Welcome to another webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, the fog crawler. I'm not cooking today, and I don't have any drone footage to show you the beautiful places we go. Today, I'm going to get into some cast iron care. I'm going to show you how to make a simple, makeshift electrolysis tank for cleaning rusty, crusty cast iron. The images in the intro are before and after shots of a Dutch oven that Pastor Bob from the church across the street brought to me a while back and asked me to clean it up for him. The results exceeded my expectations. I really thought the pot was a goner because of the amount of rust. Well, I'll tell you what, it inspired me to want to make a dedicated electrolysis tank. I'll be showing you that in a future webisode. But for now, I think it's important to show you how simple this setup and process can be. I'm just using a plastic tub, a couple of C-clamps to connect to my black pots, some spring clips, and a couple of pieces of wire to make my connections. It's that easy. Stay tuned. I'm going to show you how fast it is to make a makeshift electrolysis tank that is effective and easy and fun. I'm filling up the tank with water based on the gallons I've got. I've got some washing soda here. I'm going to dump that in. I'm going to stir this around because I want this to dissolve. You can either use Arm & Hammer's washing soda or 20 Mule Team detergent booster. I'm doing a chicken fryer today that was given to me by a neighbor. So I've got a C-clamp to make a good connection to this. And I'm just going to suspend it over the water with a piece of wood. And here's the corresponding rusty lid that he gave me. Now, what I need to do is I need to get these to where they're not touching one another. And the most important part is when I put my sacrificial steel in, that can't be touching the cast iron. Now I'm just going to connect these two plates with a very simple connection, just a spring clamp. No touchy. So now I'm going to hook up the two C clamps in the same manner. All right, I'm happy where everything is. Now I just need to raise the water level to get up above the top of this lid. That looks good. Now I can hook up the battery charger. Besides the simple makeshift electrolysis tank, you're also going to need a battery charger. You're going to want to try to find an older manual type that puts out a constant current with a timer switch versus the newer automatic ones. They don't work unless you can bypass the microprocessor. It'll detect a fully charged battery and just shut off if you try it with electrolysis. The other thing to remember is the black lead goes to the black pot. The red lead goes to the sacrificial steel. This battery charger is available right now on eBay, and I highly recommend it. It works much faster than the trickle chargers. An easy thing to remember, black lead to the black pot. Again, ensure that we're not touching. And now we can fire it up. I've got this set for 2 hours. And you can see the process is already starting. And what it pretty much does, it flows in line of sight. So in between this plate and the inside of the chicken fryer, we'll do it for 2 hours like this. Then we'll rotate and put the outer surfaces closest to the plates. Here's what it looks like after a half hour of electrolysis. All the crud is coming up. I'll tell you one thing you do not want to do is stick your finger in the water when this is going on. It'll give you shocking results. So here we are. It's been an hour. It's foaming up pretty good. More black nastiness is coming to the top. These two little windows right here, you can see the foaming, one right there and one over by this bar. Something worth noting, you want to do this in a well-ventilated area, because even with steel, this is giving off a hydrogen gas. So you want to use it in a well-ventilated area. That's why I do it outside. You can also use stainless steel as your sacrificial metal, but do note that it gives off a sulfuric acid, so definitely do not do that indoors. The electrolysis process has been going on for 2 hours now. I'm going to turn off the battery charger and disconnect everything to take a look at the cast iron to see if it needs further electrolysis. Take this one out. Oh, that's wiping right off. Great. We might be okay on that. That wipes right off. I'm going to give it a quick rinse and I'll be right back. Well, here's a shot of the inside of the lid. Here's the outside. Here's the chicken fryer itself. I'm real happy with the results. I think I can rinse this, dry it, season it. So after a thorough rinsing and a good drying in a heated oven, I put two coats of seasoning on this, and I figured it would be important to show the third and final seasoning, because a lot of people, I think, put too much on. Because after I get this fully coated, I'm actually going to take and wipe as much off as I can. You just want a very, very thin coating of seasoning on there. You put too much on and stick it in the oven, it's going to run and get drips. You don't want that. I've got a dry paper towel. Now I'm going to remove the excess. And now that's ready to put into the oven. And now I'm putting on the third and final seasoning for the lid. And now we take off the excess. Now that's ready to go into the oven as well. I hope you enjoyed today's webisode, and I also hope I inspired some of you to give electrolysis a try. It's really a pleasure to turn a rusty piece of junk into a gem of a pan. I'm Dean, the fog crawler. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors. Till the next time, happy trails to you.